Let's give a little background for a start. FareShare, as we are now, FareShare East Midlands, we started off 10 years ago, and it started off probably in this area, with us as Leicester. Some of the parish clergy made us aware that there were people who were literally starving on the streets in Leicester. There were people who were, for instance, refused asylum seekers and refugees, who had no recourse to public funds, who were given nothing. And they were sleeping in shop hallways or in skips. And the church was saying, what can we do about this? How can we deal with this? We did a little bit of research, and we discovered there was a national organisation called FareShare. Relatively little known at that time, but they had a warehouse in Birmingham. And we contacted them, and they said, well, if you bring a van over once a week, we can load you up with some tins and that sort of food, and you can manage to help people that way. So once a week, we took a white van. Went over to Birmingham and later on down to Bristol, loaded it up, brought it back to the church hall in Leicester, who allowed us to use it on Monday afternoon, and we shared it out between the groups that we had then. We had 20 groups to start off with, 10 came one week, 10 came the other week. And we just split every 10 miles. So you've got a tenth of what we had, a tithe of their food. Well, it helped a bit. Well, we ended up getting all sorts of strange food. Just after Easter, you get hundredweights of chocolate. Much the same after Christmas as well. Well, it's all very nice, pancake mix, you know. Pancake mix is, I'm sure, very useful, but you have a whole pallet load of it. It's difficult. And so we applied for funds. We got a small grant from the Church Urban Fund, and that allowed us to do a little bit more. It allowed us to have a part-time member of staff, Simone. Simone had just finished being the Dean's PA, and she took on the job. We gave her next to nothing, and she's agreed to work for a few days a week and see what she could do. Well, she now works full time for us. When I say full time, I mean 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. But she does all that off her own back. But she is amazing. But what it means is that we now have a professional organisation. We take all sorts of food now. We have grown from having a van and working out of the church hall, and we now have a warehouse on the edge of Leicester, and we have another warehouse at Homewood, just outside Chesterfield. And through those two warehouses, we supply about 240 community groups with food. All sorts of food. Not just tins and packets now. We get a huge amount of chilled food, and we will be having frozen food coming in the future. Why have we got all this food? Well, the simple fact is that there is a huge amount of food waste in the UK. Reckon that there is 1.9 million tonnes. We have just formed an alliance with the Trust and Asda, and there was a press release just yesterday, in fact, and asked her, estimate the waste food to be like 5 million tonnes. A huge amount. So why? Why is there so much waste food in this country?
Growing up, going cold, hungry.
choice to do it, and poverty. And quite honestly, a lot of it is a very simple thing, isn't it? Let's put the two together. Let's get that waste food and channel it to people who need it. It's obviously we can't do it ourselves. So we work through charities. There's a little schematic there, how we work. Okay, so there is waste food, and I'll go on to how we get it. For us, it's waste food in a bit, but a lot of waste food, and it comes to us from the food industry. They deliver it into our warehouse. We, with an army of volunteers, sort it, catalogue it, record it, and send it out. We send it out to our community food banks, the charities and organisations that are using that food. They, with some great chefs and cooks and people with imagination, turn it in to meals. And we reckon 16,500 vulnerable people get fed from our food, and that's just in East Midlands, each week. You're right, it's about today.
It's about 24,000.
So, yeah, it is out today. March 16 we produced that. Apologies for that, but yeah. But that's how we work. How does FareShare work nationally? Well, there are now 21 depots around Great Britain and Ireland. 21 trying to cover the whole country. I say trying because quite difficult. I've noticed an increase in Midlands. FareShare East Midlands covers Leicestershire, Leicester and Leicestershire, Nottingham and Nottinghamshire, Derby and Derbyshire. We cover Warwickshire, we cover a bit of Northampton, we cover Northamptonshire, we cover a little bit of Cambridgeshire. We sort of just about edge into Lincolnshire, but there are big areas of Lincolnshire that we can't cover, and it's not feasible for us to cover. The distances are just too great. We have to work where it's viable to deliver to. But you can see it's an expanding operation. It's also very expensive. You might be thinking, well, you know, Chris is trying to see where we're operating in that area. Now, how does it cost? Okay, we've got two warehouses. We pay the local authorities that we rent their warehouses, the normal rent for those warehouses. We do get a small rebate on our council tax on those warehouses, but we pay that as well. We, on FareShare East Midlands, are running five vans. Four of them are refrigerated vans. And we have some sponsorship vans. Most of it we rent from van hire people. It's a petty forestier, you may have seen them around, the chilled vans. So we rent them from those, and we have to pay for that. Yes, in today's society, we're being asked to use less fuel, and so on. We do use an awful lot of diesel. We have staff. We have some wonderful staff. Luckily, we have a huge number of volunteers as well. But we do have paid staff. And so to keep all of this, make it work, make the figures add up, we've got some grants. We get grants from Global Food Network. We get grants from local authority, and I'll come to that one in a minute. And we ask our community food members to pay a membership fee. For most of them, it's around about £1,000 a year. And for that, they're getting a weekly delivery of chilled and ambient food. And we reckon that they receive about £1,000 worth of food within about 6 to 8 weeks. So it's quite good value for them, but we don't try to kid anyone that it's a free service. The food is free, it costs money to get it.
Instead of making 500,000 pork pies a year, you
you'll be making £500,000 plus 10%, just to make sure that you've got enough to fulfil your contract. Okay, so maybe some of them are on perfect half job. So you've then got 10% of them, but you can't sell to the people who contracted to sell them to, because they didn't contract for that. But you've still got the surplus. That sort of thing comes to us. We get those seasonal stocks, you know, when the supermarkets have decided that it's going to be a stinky hot weekend. We're all told it's going to be a barbecue weekend, isn't it? That usually means a snow will be falling within the, before the day is out. And of course, the poor old shops, they're there, you know, overloaded with ice cream and burgers and everything else, and you've all got to buy stew and steak and stuff to make stew and try to keep warm. So that sort of thing happens as well. Some of the people we work with, you might recognise some of those. There's pretty well, there's most of the major retailers, but some of them, the manufacturers. It's amazing that the manufacturers have so many different varieties, and they make, of course, certainly the supermarket airlines, the ones that you go and buy as Sainsbury's tinned fruit, well, they might be drawn west, the next lot off the line. They might be Waitrose, the next lot off the line. It keeps going. Judah was about to say something.
So they can then take it.
Yeah,
so
that's right. So some of our community group members are people like the Welcome Project here in Leicester who support asylum seekers and refugees. They basically are receiving food parcels. So the same sort of thing that you would get from the food bank. It's ambient food, so it's tins, packets, because they haven't got refrigeration or freezer space to keep this, and they haven't got catering facilities to produce it. So they pass that on. Quite a lot of it goes out to community cafes around the East Midlands. They take that food, they make meals out of it. Some of it goes to hospitals. Probation Trust receives some of this. It goes to hospitals and is used to support people in those hospitals. Some of it actually still goes to the food banks. And our latest alliance with ASDA and Trussell Trust means that FareShare will be supporting Trussell Trust food banks with fresh produce through our delivery network. And that will be coming from ASDA. So yeah, I mean, that's the national figure. It is a huge, huge operation. But we still have to face the question. The question comes about regions. Why? Why is this necessary? Why is it necessary in this country that we're producing 28.6 million meals? Why? There's 13,500 tons of food, and we're only scratching the surface, being available. Well, that's a political question. I'm not going to try and answer it, because I think there are quite a lot of people who are attempting to, and I also think it is a question that the churches of all denominations, in fact all the faith groups in this country, should be asking and should be holding society to do that challenge. Why? Why are we allowing this to happen? Okay, so what do some of our members say? Well, we're doing all sorts of things, drop-in services, lunch clubs, breakfast clubs. Breakfast clubs are very popular in schools. It's an interesting fact that so many school children are going to school without having had a good breakfast. Any of you who've ever been in education will know that trying to teach a child who is hungry, you're on a loser. They need to have enough to eat before you start trying to educate them. If they've come to school with no breakfast, and all too many have, you're lost. So we could have produced, with the aid of especially people like Kellogg's, who provided the cereals to go into schools for breakfast. Just something simple, like a yogurt, a bowl of cereal, a glass of fruit juice. Amazing, the change in things. Suddenly, you can do things. And it can be done for next to nothing. It's not expensive. As I said, there are hospitals. Hospitals for homeless. Winter hostels in Derby, in Leicester, we've been supporting, so that people who have nowhere to sleep at least have myself with some chance of getting a decent deal in the loan.
Read that for yourself.
believe that the no good food should go to waste. Nationally, we're probably using about 5 to 7% of the food that goes to waste. That's all. There's an awful lot more of it. So we need to change. We need to change our structures. We need to change the way that we operate as a country. It's a big challenge. We're not alone. FareShare are not the only people operating in this. People like Church Urban Fund, Global Alliance on Food Quality, they're all working at it. I suppose the real people that need to start thinking are those who are in Westminster, because they have the power to change. They have the funds to change. But in the meantime, people at FareShare are going to be there operating at the sharp end. We're going to be there feeding people. And with the help of good people like yourselves, with your prayers, with your support, with your help, we will carry on going. Now, we're very happy to